One day he did come back, but he was accompanied by a woman he had married under the laws of his own country. And now poor Butterfly must die by her own hand, according to the ancient traditions of honor. But first, she must bid a sad farewell to her child.
Con onor muore chi non può serbar vita con onore.
Che vedrestia la tra In 1911, one of the first truly American operas was performed at the Metropolitan Opera House. The stars were Mary Garden and John McCormick, and it was written by Victor Herbert. It tells the story of Natoma, an Indian girl, who is caught in tragic conflict between pride in her ancestry and loyalty to the Spanish strangers. To protect her Spanish mistress, she has killed a man and has sought sanctuary in the mission church. In her distracted mind, she hears an ancient Indian lullaby, and she calls to the Indian god to help her in this tragic hour.
That only echoes my
Selections from Rossini's comic opera, The Barbara of Seville, with two of the leading singers from the Metropolitan Opera. In this scene, Figaro describes his many-sided life as a barber in Seville, singing the familiar Largo al Factotum, the famous baritone Mr. Robert
Figaro, bravo, 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 b notte e giorno sempre vittoria nei giro sta che li compagni per un barbiere vita vera vera l'ansietà la 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 Bella risorsa di voi del mestiere
e con la donnetta
e col cavaliere
e con la donnetta
col cavaliere e la 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 oh, che bel vivere, che bel piacere, che bel piacere per un barbiere di qualità, di qualità. Tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono. Donna ragazzi, vengono fanciulle,
e quale parrucca?
Presta la barba, il cuore sanguigno, presta il lievo, mi vogliono, quale parrucca, presta la barba, presta il lievo.
Figaro, 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 Figaro,
ahimè, che furia di me, che folla, pugna della volta, per carità, per carità. Una alla volta, una alla volta, mi ricorda.
Figaro, su qua, e Figaro, su qua, qua, figaro là, qua, figaro su, figaro giù, figaro su, figaro giù, figaro su, con il prezzissimo figaro, con il prezzissimo
balcone, dalle città, dalle città, dalle città, dalle città, dalle città. Bravo Figaro, bravo bravissimo, bravo Figaro, bravo bravissimo, fortunatissimo, 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 per bonito. Bravo Figaro, bravo bravissimo, bravo Figaro, bravo bravissimo, che era fatune, che era fatune, che era fatune, non mancherò. Sarei il fatto come della città, sarei il fatto come della città, della città. Presto, presto, qua il biglietto.
Un biglietto? E Figaro, vieni qui un momentino. Eccolo qua.
Già era scritto.
Sì.
Vecchia bestia, vecchia bestia. Il maestro bacio è lei. In cattedra costei di mai già detta.
Tu sacro marto sei che mi devi consolare, che mi consolare.
Donne, donne eternide, donne, donne eternide,
senti, quando
qui verrà, a momenti per parlarmi qui sarà, tutto zitto qui verrà. Eternidei,
che la Veneta infiora, e là fuggevol, fuggevol, la sinebria voluta, riviale dolci fremiti che suscita l'amore, poiché quell'occhio al cuore onnipotente va. Viviamo, amore, amor, tra i cari, ci più cari baciamo.
Viviamo, caro, che ci più cari baciamo.
Quell'amor misterioso altera, croce, croce delizia, croce delizia, delizia al cuore.
From Act 4 of Il Trovatore, Miss Price sings D'Amor sul Ali Rosé, in which she bids the breezes of the night carry her sighs to her lover, who has been imprisoned in the tower of the castle and condemned to death.
Salvarlo io potrò.
aburrido rivale mi sfuggirò. Noi sacerdoti rovesa tende, nei traditori la pena, traditori gli non è. Rivelò di guerra l'alto segreto, egli fuggir voleva, con lei fuggire, traditori tutti a voi.
Yeah! Pagliaccio! On September 16, 1960, at the Bolshoi Theater in Moscow, an audience of 2,000 rose from their seats and gave a standing ovation to the superlative American bass baritone George London, the first non-Russian ever to perform the title role in Russia's best-loved national opera, Boris Godunov, at the Bolshoi Theater. To George London, this was the climax of a lifelong dream, a tremendous personal triumph, and the greatest of the many great moments in his career. Tonight he recreates for the Bell Telephone Hour a scene from this spectacular performance. This scene takes place in the great reception hall of the Kremlin. In the final act of the opera, the Tsar, Boris, becomes obsessed with a feeling of guilt, realizing that his secret, the murder of the rightful heir, and his usurping of the throne is known to all. He is seized with a frightening premonition of death.
Help! Choking! Choking! Help me!
Go quickly! Bring my son! I cannot breathe. Cannot. Leave us alone. Go. All of you. Farewell, my son. I am dying. From now on, you shall be the Tsar. You must not ask. Don't ask how I ascended to the throne. My son, you need not know. Tsar, you shall be and rightful ruler. As my successor, my son, my first begotten. Dear son, my own. Beloved Fyodor, do not trust the boyars and their words. They are liars. Never forget that some are traitors in league with Lithuania. And traitors must always be punished. Destroy them without mercy. Yet to be just in your judgment, listen to your people. Always fight for the faith, defend the true belief. Honor all the saints and ask them to bless. Son, protect her and be kind to her, for now you are her brother and her father. Love and treasure her, so pure, so tender. God above, oh my God, look down, I pray, upon a sinful father's tears. Not for myself, I pray, not for myself, oh Father. Father, see.
see my children, send to them the light of thine unending love. Protect them both forever. They are guiltless angels of God the Lord, guardians of the eternal throne. Unfold your shining wings to give him a refuge. Protect my son, my Fyodor, from every ill and from temptation. Here, it's the bell of death.
Regine Crespin as Amelia, and Franco Corelli as the King of Sweden.
mia, il rimorso di lacera e rode, quel suo grido non cura, non ode, s'incalenti e di fremiti amor. Non sai tu che di te resteria se cessasse di battere il cor? Quante notti ho vegliato anelante, come a lungo infelice lottai, quante volte al cielo implorai la pietà che tu chiedi da me, ma per questo potuto mi spante il felice non vivere di me.
Mi soccorre dal cielo lontana,
thank you. pungermi così.
Oh,
la sua vicina che la vien fuori d'ora importunare.
Later, Mario in his cell. He is writing his last letter to Tosca and remembering.
Le belle forme, oh Dio! canto.
Oh,
Joan Sutherland as Lucia de Lammermoor. It was Miss Sutherland's debut with the Metropolitan Opera Company and the foremost event of the current musical year. Tonight, the Bell Telephone Hour recreates her final minutes of that evening, the singing of the mad scene. Miss Sutherland as Lucia.
Thank you. Oh.